Hi, welcome to Numerix Video Blog. I'm your host, Jim Joggle. With me today, Saul Stepner, Managing Director of America Sales. Saul, how are you?
Excellent, Jim. How are you?
Very good. Saul, I want to talk to you. Saul, by background, is quite an expert in insurance, and I wanted to pick your brain on a couple topics today. Namely, post-2008, two things we're continuing to see. Number one, a return of rising interest rates. But two, availability of investment funds. So assets under management are continuing to grow for many institutions. How are insurance companies reacting to these two market events?
Sure. So you touched on a few very important points here: the rise in interest rate and really kind of a rise in consumer confidence out there is creating a lot more wealth and a lot more consumers who want to put money into retirement solutions. So insurance companies are thinking about this, and they're actually putting a lot of plans into action. They're starting to look at their product portfolios, de-risking some of the guarantees that they've made that are unsustainable, and actually starting to create new types of product offerings that really offer the types of guarantees and retirement solutions that these consumers are looking for. One example of that type of product would be an FIA. We're seeing an increase in fixed index annuities of all different types of categories, but that's something that we've seen as a trend in the industry.
So you mentioned de-risking unsustainable guarantees. So, you know, but for way of knowledge, 2008, it wasn't just the market environment and the underlyings that created challenges around the products, but it was also guarantees that the product couldn't live up to post that environment. What is being taken into consideration now in the product design that hasn't been taken into consideration prior to 2008?
Sure, great question, Jim. So one of the trends that we've been seeing in the product design is really in the underlying funds. So we're starting to see a lot of the hedging taking place in the underlying funds themselves. So managed vol is a perfect example where a lot of the carriers are offering variable annuities with choices of managed vol funds as underlying investments. Those managed vol funds basically have a natural hedge built into them, right? And then the risk manager at the insurance company, they're calling it hedge around the edge, hedging the residual risk out.
So what has fundamentally changed though, right? So I think about, you know, different levels of sophistication on the asset side and the liability side of many houses and capital markets, especially if, you know, we think about annuity products as a derivative, which just happens to have different elements involved in it from an actuarial science, as compared to a traditional derivative where much has a shorter maturity. What is being done or changed in the modeling approach of these products to ensure that things are being hedged appropriately and the products themselves will perform as expected by investors?
Well, you know, the industry has gotten smarter. Obviously, you learn from the lessons of the past. And one of the things that we're seeing happen now is a lot of the insurance companies looking at ways to project their hedging strategies forward. So once they come up with the hedging strategy, whether it's a hedging strategy, as I mentioned, that takes place for the most part in the underlying funds themselves, or traditional three Greek hedging strategies, they're running, you've heard the term stochastic on stochastic, so they're running basically a stochastic projection to look at how those hedges will perform through time. And as a result, by the way, a lot of insurance clients are getting relief on capital by putting forth a clearly defined hedging strategy, which requires you to have this hedge strategy simulation in place.
So I want to follow up on that question, right? Because once we start talking stochastic on stochastic, right, or otherwise known nested stochastic, right, creates considerable amount of compute challenges. And then when we think of the blocks of annuities that we're talking millions of policies against millions of paths against nested stochastic issues. What kind of cost is related to this business, and how are companies looking to manage not just a big data problem, but the big compute problem as well?
That's a great question, and it's actually an area that's really exciting for us at Numerix. The answer to your question is really the cloud. A lot of the carriers, the big carriers out there, are looking to move applications to the cloud and really leverage the likes of Microsoft's Azure platform. One of our large clients actually they're in the process of moving over 60% of their actuarial models into a cloud environment. And really, you know, you asked about the cost. So partially there's a big cost savings involved, but also if you think about it, you need the compute when you need it, whether it's monthly or on a quarterly basis. You never know what the exact demands will be. So to the extent that you could have the cloud, you could spin up these environments on demand, that's creating not only cost savings, but opportunity.
So one final question.
Sure.
So we've seen several insurers, as well as asset managers and hedge funds, moving around large blocks of VAs, right? And some exiting the business, others entering. In terms of some of the experiences you're seeing of best practices, what are a couple things that individuals should be thinking about if they're going to be entering that business, especially as it relates to this big data, big compute, and modeling challenge?
Right. So you got to be smart about it, right? You have to, as you're getting into this business, really take a look at your technology stack and what you have in place. Insurance companies are really known for having a lot of legacy environments, and there's a big trend today. Insurance companies who are in the business and those getting into the business actually taking a look at these legacy systems, getting sunsetting some of the legacy systems and getting onto newer platforms really that have the capability to work with the cloud, to really model the stochastic interest rates and other factors in the right way, all leading up to, you know, really answering at the end of the day both the numbers they need from an internal hedging and risk perspective, but also responding to the regulators like NAIC with the ORSA, the changes in IFRS and GAAP accounting standards. So there's a real need to put the right systems in place and the right technology that's scalable, that's flexible, and provides really a roadmap for the future.
Well, Saul, thank you so much for joining our video blog, and I hope you'll join us again sometime in the future. Please stay on top of everything we're doing here at Numerix. Please follow us along on LinkedIn on the page. We have links to all of our upcoming events and webinars and the conferences that we're attending. And, of course, we want to talk about the topics that you want to talk about. So please feel free to follow us at NX Analytics on Twitter. We'll catch you next time. Thank you.
Thank you.